Hello everyone and welcome to the second free-to-play day-to-day video. So, as you can see, overnight my building and my research got finished, and I wanted to show you quickly what I'm doing whenever I have time. So one thing is I do the events where I can send out my probes. I just go to someone. You can also get these from researching. I'll send it out and investigate and just do this. I do this with two probes usually. So the other thing is, at one point you will run out of these investigations and you go to your system map. So if you're in your starport, just click on Galaxy. Scroll a little bit out or move around and you will see these systems with a question mark. You just click on them and you do prospect. If you do explore, they only will explore it, but if you do prospect, your probe will explore and prospect it. So you will already get a reward from this. Whenever you got time, you then can just collect them. You will get some materials, some resources and core XP, so this is always good to have. Okay, so the next thing is with the research, we are already able to build the T3 destroyers. We are also going to research towards the T3 frigates and cruisers, mainly to have higher level support during the campaign mission. The other thing that we are researching is under development. We want to expand the dock, but this needs research level 8. As soon as we get there, we get additional recruit leadership. That means we can build more warships with each build. So that will be the next thing as soon as we get our research center high enough. Till we get there, we continue researching towards T3 ships. For the shipbuilding, the only ship you want to build is the Kraken class destroyer 1. So this is a T2 destroyer, and the reason why you want to build it, it got 837 load. If we look at the other ships, they got a much lower load per leadership. So I did a few other videos in the past, and let me quickly pull this up here. Okay, so here we got it. I got all the ships, the warships here, and all frigates need 3 leadership, all destroyer, no matter which tier, level 10, and all cruisers 30. So what we are looking right now is the load capacity of these ships. I'll make it very simple. I will just add another column here and I will call it load per leadership. So this is the leadership, the load divided by the leadership, and let's fill it out to the bottom up. Okay. So then we will copy this over here. We just have to move this one down there. And very quickly, you will now see that there is for the destroyer tier 2, there's a big jump. So let me quickly also do it just to show it to you. Need to get this down here. Fill out the formula. Okay, so If we look at our frigates, it's going up every second frigate at the beginning and later every frigate, the load increases. To get to something like 80, you need to be able to build tier 10 or tier 11 for the frigates. For the cruisers, same thing, at the beginning, every second level it goes up. They will never go to a value of 80 or higher for the load. And for the destroyers, we also start there at the 40 range and we will end somewhere at the 113 range. But the tier 2 destroyers, they do give you 84 load per leadership, which you would need to be able to build tier 8, tier 9 destroyers later. We already said for the cruisers, you will never be able to get an 80 value. For the frigates, you need to be able to build tier 10 or tier 11. So tier 2 cruisers are your transport warships. If you want to be able to transport a lot of resources, tier 2 destroyers are the ones that will allow you to do this easiest and fastest. To get to tier 8, 9, 10 warships, it will take you a long time. So these are the ships I am going to build for the next weeks or however long it needs. We already now got the buildings that we have the second queue. So we can now build two times these ships every time. So this will allow us to increase our strength much faster, increase our load much faster. Another thing I like about them, they are missile type, so they work perfectly together with the flagships that we have now at the beginning. And flagship is the next thing I want to quickly talk about. We do have a flagship that does have missile bonus as a first skill. And the other bonus, I have a video talking about all the extras, all the benefits from the flagships. Take a look at that. We built at the beginning because of the tutorial a coil cannon, which does not make sense because we are going to equip our warship with missiles. So the next thing I'm now starting to do is I am starting to build equipment for that. For this, we need to build an outfitting factory. So just get this upgraded as far as you can, because the higher the outfitting factory, the higher later you can upgrade your equipment. And now we do not want to build kinetic weapon. We want to build. I know I have to do this now because of the tutorial. We want to build missiles. So if you looked at the flagship, you do have four slots for weapons and four slots for defensive protective equipment. So first thing, we go to missiles and we are building four times the missile weapon. For protection, you have the choice for armor, for shield, and for HP. At the beginning, I recommend you to go with HP. So, same thing, I'm going to build as soon as I have the materials, I'm going to build four times the HP modules. If you do have enough resources, you can start upgrading. As you can see, I'm missing these black crystals. You can break down existing equipment. So we had to build these kinetic weapons. I will break them down. For green equipment, breaking down is free. Later, you will have to pay if it's higher level equipment. So we only have the four missile types left. Let's see, still not enough to build the HP modules. So when we go back to the flagship, we now can click on this slot and we can gear our missile type. So, two reasons why we do this. So first thing, it will have a fleet effect. It will help you in all fights, also versus pirates. And if you click on battle stats, it gives you an attack of 41 every 4 seconds with a range of 6, and it launches 6 missiles in the campaign. And the campaign is something we will try to progress now also, because you will get really nice rewards in the campaign. Okay, so we already got now the weapons. We can look to modify, but for modify you do need blueprints. We won't do this at the moment, but we can already fortify. Fortify is giving XP to your flagship, and then all your stats will go up. If you modify, your skills will be also increased. Important to note is you do have a level from your building. If you go to your building and you can build the flagship dock, so this is level 6. You will see that we also upgrade this because the flagship dock level 6 will allow your flagship to get up to level 12. So we will just get our flagship up. I will not get it to level 12 because then I'm at the limit and my flagship cannot level up anymore. If I have enough flagship XP, I would bring it up to level 11. So we now got the equipment, we do have it leveled up. If you click here on the right, we can now also add the destroyers that we were building. Just add them, save. Down here you see the leadership limit of your flagships. This will increase as soon as you upgrade your flagship. If you level it up, you will get more. There's also research, and you can get bonus somewhere else, so from crew members, stuff like this. But at the moment we don't have enough warships anyhow. This all gives us now a strength of 31,000. The good thing is we already know that we have missile frigates, we do have missile we have missile destroyers, we have a missile warship, so that will work well. And what we can do now is we can kill marauders. So these ones, level 6, have 26,000 power. As said, we already have 31,000 power. That will be easy. The higher the pirates you kill, the more rewards you get. I did kill some pirates last time. So the first time you kill, you do get additional rewards, but every time after this you kill, you get the normal loot. And the number of crates you get is based on the level of marauder you kill. So level 4 gives you 4 crates, level 5 gives you 5 crates, level 6 will give you 6 crates, and so on. Therefore, you always want to kill the highest possible pirates you can. You do have the energy up here, up to 1000, it recharges automatically, and you can also use revitalizers if you need to. I would keep the revitalizers for now. We will just send our warship as it is to sea to kill as high as possible pirates. And the nice thing, even if your warship is in fights or is collecting resources, you can always go to the campaign as soon as you get high enough. So to progress in the campaign, we have to join an alliance. You have to do this. If possible, sure, you want to join the highest possible alliance, but for just progressing, you can just look through all of these little bit, and some of them, they will allow you to join immediately, or you can apply to join. Another option is you just go to the global chat and you say something like new player looking for alliance. Mainly later when you hire, you will be able to also join good alliances. This is something you really want to do. But at the beginning, now we just want to be able to progress this emission. So we will just try to find whatever lines we can join. We don't really care. We will leave it as soon as we are able to, yeah, to be strong enough and to find a better alliance. If you go to your profile, you can go to the ranking. There's alliance power ranking. Usually you will probably try to find one of the top five, or yeah, top five alliances. If I click on Armageddon, they are full at the moment, so probably not a chance to join them. I can't read Taiwanese, I think it is. Some alliances will already tell you what requirements they have, or also if they have a union. So if you see here, these have a union with Armageddon, that would be also perfect, but they are also full. Anyhow, you will need a little bit more power to be accepted by them. Yeah, so try to find an alliance. During that time, continue with killing pirates. Also, killing pirates will give you additional XP for your flagship. So you can always see here flagship XP 72. The higher pirates you kill, the more XP you get, and so on and so on. So we already set up our fleet, we leveled up our flagship. Let's take a look at our depot. So as said, you don't want to open any of the resource crates. Next, we do have the speed ups. If you want to, you can use them. There are some events that require you to build things fast, or the faster you build it, or the more you build, the more points you get. I will keep my speed ups on most of them for this. Buffs, I don't use that right now, I will use this later. Under others, we do have some things that we want to use now. Corium crates you can always get. Corium cannot be stolen from you. Spaceport core modules. We want to use these because then we get additional rewards, we level up our core, which will also give us additional bonies. So we will go into these very soon. You can also open the material chests. These will allow you to build more or upgrade more of your equipment for your flagship. So as we just opened a few of them, we can now check the outfitting factory and see if we can upgrade something. No, but maybe we are now able to build our HP module. We got one of these black living metal things, so at least we can build one. We can go to our flagship, select this, click here, gear, and now as you can see, before our base stat was 5.3k HP, we got an additional 4.9k HP. So this is a huge upgrade for us, especially at the beginning, and this will allow us very likely to engage higher level pirates. So we can try this level 8 again now. Always take a look at the events. The Galaxy Star event is one that I mentioned, where you need to build things or rank up things quickly, so I will keep my speed ups for this. Here we do have one that also requires speed ups. I do like the bonus there, but 800, 180 mints and stuff like this, it's a lot. Not sure if I really can get there. The Space Academy, you will just get these automatically. You don't really need to worry while you play every day and do everything. You will automatically get all of these. You can take a look if you want to what is missing, day one, day two, day three, and you can try to speed up your progress there a little bit. That's like exploring star systems. So exploring star systems, you say, as said before, you just go to the galaxy map. You select a star system with a question mark, you say explore or prospect, both is counting, and you do send your probes out there. I got a video how to do this the most efficient way. if you want to just take a look there, and it will help you to maximize your progress there. We are still on the military tree. We now can research the next frigates there and go. That's 1 hour. What else do we have? I think that's the main thing we are looking forward right now. So the next thing is I want to try to find an alliance that I can progress with the main mission and that our campaign is getting free. During the campaign and the quests, we did get the blueprints for an additional flagship. So we can now build the Jason. You will get other blueprints later, but yeah, you want to have a second flagship because it allows you to do more things in parallel. So we will get our resources from the crates to be able to build it, and we will start the build. So in 1 hour, we will have another flagship, and then we can send this flagship out to gather resources. That's it. See, we already have the slot here. Let's see, were we able to kill? Okay, we are failing at level 8 pirates right now. So I will just continue farming level 7 pirates till my energy is low. Then I will send my flagship to farm some materials. You can look at your map. You at the beginning will have titanium, deuterium for sure. It doesn't matter if you choose a level 3, level 1. The gathering speed is the same. The only thing that changes is how long your flagship will stay there. So overnight you want the highest possible. Also make sure that you have enough load capacity to be able to farm the higher levels completely. If not, just stay with a little bit lower level, as your flagship will return anyhow as soon as the load capacity is full. The only last thing we can do, as you see, we do have a few more crew slots here. We can do some crew recruitment. So we got 1,000 prestige points that will allow us to recruit two more crew members. And we will do this just because of the bonus we get from crew members. For now, we do not have more crew members than slots, so we can just assign them. As you see, there's a green arrow up. That means I did pull this guy twice. He did got modified or broke down to ID cards, and I can use these ID cards to advance him. Advancing means that these bonies will go one level higher. As you see, I do not level up my crew members right now. I will very likely start as soon as I get the first legendary for sure. Till then, I will keep my crew XP because I cannot get it refunded. So crew XP you use will always stay with this crew member. For your flagship, you can reset your flagship. The first one is free, later you have to pay, and you get all the flagship XP back. But if you modify your flagship, you will not get the blueprints back or the Federation credit that you need to spend to buy blueprints later. So therefore, I would recommend you do not buy blueprints for flagships, as you will get better flagships very, very soon. And you want to use all your credits to buy the blueprints for these better flagships then. Okay, so that's the day one is over, so that's now the second day of playing Infinite Galaxy on the free-to-play account. Hope you got a good idea. I hope next video I make, so tomorrow we will see that I was able to join an alliance. And therefore, here there's someone. Lex is recruiting members after level 12. So I'm not level 12 yet. We are at level 7 comment center. So we still need to wait. We still need to find someone. who is getting noobs, like we are. Okay. Yeah. Hope you enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. Check the other videos in my channel to learn in more details about some of the aspects of the game. And see you on the next video. Okay, just a very quick adding. Directly after I finished the video, I was able to join an alliance. So what I can do now is I just can click or go to the campaign, select a mission, and go through this. So if you did everything as I showed it to you, these missions should be very easy. So you can just go to by two speed at the beginning and directly charge into the enemy. You should have so much HP and firepower that you will just annihilate them. You don't even need to call your reinforcements. It should be super, super easy and quick. And whenever you finish these, you do get rewards. So if you finish them in the time limit without getting below 60% of your HP, so kills all enemies, then you get the first chest. Flagship above 60%, you get the second chest. And if you also are able to do this in the time limit, you get the third chest. And as you see, the rewards are pretty nice. There's a lot of resources, a lot of XP. And I want to show this to you to go quickly through that. Because the last mission of each chapter does give you additional rewards. So we will very, very quickly go through this here. If you installed the additional missiles, these have no chance of survival. So as you see, we do even kill all of them before our reinforcement can arrive. And yeah, they just managed to get through our shield. Our HP is still up and it's already done. So another three chests. That's a lot of flagship XP and resources that we can use to upgrade. So now we come to the last mission of this chapter. You do get blueprints for the Hercules and you do get Federation credits that you will need later to buy more blueprints also for other flagships. So in later levels you will also get more blueprints for other flagships, so this will be a resource for you to get these flagships. You can important thing is, as you see, we already got the T3 research ready for the destroyer. So if we now call reinforcements, it is T3 destroyers. The other ships are still T2. That's the reason why you want to progress also the research on your warships to be able to call in the big reinforcements. Okay, so yeah, as said, this goes very easy and quickly. And we won again. Okay, so another thing, as soon as you join the alliance, so yeah, really nice rewards. Go out of this. And as soon as you joined an alliance, you do get the alliance tab here. You can help research and buildings from your alliance people, and also they can help you as soon as you build the embassy. Here we do have it. So as you see, people can help me 9 times with the embassy level 5. We will already start upgrading our command center. We always try to get it to the highest possible level. Now that we can do, and then we can click seek help. So they will help us. Every help usually is like around 2 minutes reduction in the time. I did not port into the Alliance territory as I do not think I will stay with this Alliance for a long time, and as long as I'm below level 10, I'm still protected by my shield. So, as you see, I got a bubble around me. People cannot attack me. People cannot get my resources yet. And the other thing, that's a very, very important thing, I cannot stress this enough. Try not to open, not try, do not open your crates. Your storage center gives you a certain amount of resources that are protected. As you see, these are level 5, it's nearly 400,000. We have only 5,000, 4,000 resources. So if you open all your crates immediately, these values can jump over your protected storage, and then it's very likely that a high-level player comes, attacks you, and takes away these resources that are not protected. If you just follow my recommendations, this won't happen because it makes no sense for any player to attack me. They can't get anything from me. And if they attack me, they will have maybe a few losses. But without getting any resources to recover these losses, it's pointless for them to start an attack. Okay, so everything else stays the same. I will continue attacking the pirates. I will do the campaign as far as I can get. I will continue building tier 2 destroyers, and my research, as said before, will go into the here in the development in the expand dock as soon as I got the research center high enough. During the other time, I will try, or I will focus on getting the tier 3 warships available, which will also help me to progress more in the campaign mission. Okay, so yeah, now it got a little bit longer again. Sorry for that. Hope it was still a good video, and see you on the next one.